What is going on, everyone? This is Eric coming at you from just outside of Hartford, Connecticut. And today, we're going to continue with our MLB Pipeline's Top 100 Prospects for the 2021 season. And we're going to look at the AL West today. So, as we have in the previous videos, we'll look at the first team here, alphabetically speaking. And basically what it is the number before their name is their 2021 rank. Then you have their position. Then you have their name. And lastly, we have their 2020 rank, if they were ranked. So we'll start off with the Houston Astros, and they have one player in the top 100, and that's going to be the 41st ranked right-handed pitcher, Forrest Whitley. And Whitley's been a bit of a disappointment, so to speak. He's been dealing with some injuries in the recent years, which is why he fell from 19 to 41 this past season. Houston's farm system is nowhere near what it used to be. Obviously, that's the downside of having a World Series contender like Houston has had in the recent years. They had to give up a lot of big name prospects to get players such as Justin Verlander, Gerrit Cole, but I think they're fine with that. Still, not the strongest farm system. Whitley, if he can stay healthy, is a very good player, but that's a big if. Next, we have the LA Angels. So the Angels did just have one of the top prospects in baseball, outfielder Joe Adell, graduate. Other than that, they have the 53rd ranked outfielder, Brandon Marsh, and the 74th ranked left-handed pitcher, Reed Detmers, as their two players in the top 100. So Brandon Marsh has actually had a big going up arrow. A lot of people are really high on him. He looked very good in the 2019 Arizona Fall League. He looked very good at the alternate training site in 2020 for them. Detmers, highly drafted pick. They're hoping. They have a lot of hope for him. Next, we have the only team that does not have a single prospect in the top 100, and the Oakland Athletics. Now, the Athletics have been good in recent years, and they just haven't been hitting on their guys. They go for more, you know, lower ceiling players that will make the majors on cheaper contracts. So, unfortunately for Oakland, they're not going to really have a top farm system. But they have a lot of guys that'll make it to the majors and just contribute and be like career two war guys, you know, guys who contribute but don't do much of anything. So unfortunately, Oakland is there, and they have had a few players graduate in recent years as well, which of course hurts your farm system. But fact of the matter is, you need a good farm system to have a good parent club. And if your farm system's a little weak right now, but your parent club's doing good, that's fine. Next, we have the Seattle Mariners, who have the strongest farm system in this division. They have six players in the top 100, and they have two top five, both outfielders, with the fourth-ranked Jared Kelenic and the fifth-ranked Julio Rodriguez. They also have 31st-ranked right-handed pitcher Emerson Hancock, 33rd-ranked right-handed pitcher Logan Gilbert, 92nd-ranked right-handed pitcher George Kirby, and they end the list with the 100th-ranked outfielder Taylor Trammell. So, three outfielders, three right-handed pitchers, pretty strong farm system. Kelenic looks very good. He looks like he might make his debut in early 2021. Seattle fans can only hope. He'll be a big addition to that team. As for the rest of them, Trammell also should make his debut in 2021, or at least graduate from prospect status in 2021, I should say. As for the rest of them, Gilbert, Kirby, they look like they'll be getting to the big leagues soon, probably. Hancock, just drafted. Rodriguez, the fact that he's the fifth-ranked prospect in baseball tells you a lot about him. He's young, he's talented, get ready for him. Lastly, we have the Texas Rangers, who have three players in the top 100. They have the 63rd-ranked third baseman, Josh Swung, 78th-ranked catcher, Sam Huff, and the 91st-ranked right-handed pitcher, Dane Dunning. So, it's an interesting farm system. Texas takes a lot of swings in the draft. They try to get a lot of guys who, you know, they want to get the guys who have a high ceiling but a low floor. So they hope that they can hit on, like, the next Mike Trout. Unfortunately, it hasn't been working in recent years. So Josh Swung and Dane Dunning are both guys that probably will make the majors pretty soon. Sam Huff will also be graduating for prospect status pretty soon as well. So these are all guys that don't typically fit the mold of what Texas goes for, but they have to be happy with what they're getting. So yeah, that was the AL West. Again, sorry if you're an Oakland fan, but Don't be too upset. You at least have a good major league team right now, unlike some of us. Yeah, Seattle, your future is bright. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. This was the AL West. Have a good one.